presents CFA football, a big one in the Big Ten. The Ohio State Buckeyes and the Penn State Nittany Lions. The colors of autumn starting to appear on the landscape surrounding Beaver Stadium, where today's game will be played. A bit of a surprise, they won the toss, elect to defer and take the ball of the second half. It is Curtis Enis and Ambrose Fletcher waiting for it. Penn State, and Enis catches the ball. It's Wally Richardson. He's a junior, 6'4", 215, out of Sumter, South Carolina. He set a school record with completed passes, 33 out of 48, in last week's loss to Wisconsin, a loss, incidentally, that snapped Penn State's 20-game win streak and 21 consecutive at home. The Lions will open now with Mike Archie and Jon Witman in the backfield behind the Richardson. They've got Scott in motion, a wide receiver. They run it with Archie trying to get around the corner. He gets across the 10 to the 11. Matt Finkus makes the tackle. The Chili's starting lineup with the backs and receivers now for the Nittany Lions, who are wearing the home blue shirts. Bobby Engram is the big play man, number 10, a wide receiver. But when people get doubly absorbed with him, Freddie Scott usually has a big day.
He caught a bunch of balls. In fact, 13 passes Scott catch last week when all the attention was at Engram.
They're calling it second down and six. The ball is just beyond the 11, and Richardson quickly over the middle. The pass completed for a first down to the tight end, Keith Oldsmer. Now, the way Ohio State played defense last week against Notre Dame, the tight end was available most of the day. He may be open a lot this afternoon. Jeff Hardings is the big guy up front for them. He leads. He's an All-American. He is from Ohio, incidentally, and was a high school teammate and friend of the Buckeyes starting quarterback Bobby Hoying. But it's a very good offensive front for the Nittany Lions. They go to the fullback, and you can hear the whacking and cracking all the way to Belfont Pound. He's your tailback. Richardson takes it, rolls it out. He's got some room to run and decides 28 or thereabouts. And back Richardson gets chased a bit, throws the ball over the man, wide open. It's the five strings waiting back just beyond the 30. Snap is good, the kick is away, and it's a fine kick. He goes all the way back to the 15 to pick it up. Gets away from one, and they cut him down at the 20. Big crowd of 95,000 plus. Hoying changing, calling the play at the line of scrimmage, and he's going to have a hoarse voice if he tries to do that all day on that lineup right now. Back goes Bobby Hoying for his first pass. It's thrown out to Eddie George. George has the fullback, Nicky Sualua, third down and 13. Hoying's pass, good. It is caught by the tight end, Ricky Dudley, wide. Give it to Enis. To the 45-yard.
Mike Archie is in the backfield. Good pass receiver. Richardson looking around, goes down the middle with it, hits the man. That's Engram.
Bobby Engram will make it first down. Nittany Lions at the Ohio State.
Last week against Wisconsin, they did not hit the square ends. They had not, no play for Penn State last week was over 20 yards.
Buckeyes show blitz, can't pass through there. And Richardson pass again, down the middle, caught by Freddie Scott. First down at the 14-13 yard line.
Receivers just run straight down, but from the right side of your screen, a square in. The flanker runs a square in. If he catches this ball and keeps going out the other side, he can run away from everybody.
Buckeyes show six-man front here. Hand the ball off to the tailback, Archie. Archie looking for daylight. Finds enough to get him down to the six-yard line.
We've got three fullbacks
That's
in there.
That's the elephant backfield.
Elephant backfield.
And it is the biggest of the big, Jon Witman, and he's going to have the first down. It'll be first and goal for Penn State.
And goal from the three.
Richardson hands the ball to Witman. Touchdown.
Defense straight blocking, the three fullbacks are in there, and Belisari, number 30, never had a chance. Nice blocking. 10
Not
plays
to have real grass,
yeah. I agree, Keith. 10 plays, 60 yards, a nice drive, and got it in on the ground. I think Joe's gonna like that one.
Ball bouncing around and will roll into the end zone. It must be a little bit soft down there.
bounces away. Pass is caught by George, and Eddie will have
by some 45 pounds by the Buckeyes offensive front. Terry Killins is linebacker size, as we told you, playing a defensive end. Brad Scioli, Brandon Noble, and Eric Clare has moved in from having some trouble early on. Aaron Collins, Gerald Filardi, and Jim Nelson are your linebackers. And again, the guy in the middle is the leading tackler. Single back, Eddie George. First down, Buckeye. George has got it. Looks, finds a little daylight. His progress will be up to around the 34. He's second down and six. The defensive secondary for Penn State, and you like this group, don't you, Bob?
I do. I like Brian Miller a lot, Mark Tate on the other corner, but Kim Herring, the free safety, is just outstanding.
Jason Collins would have been the hero back, but he heard it broke a leg.
That's the strength of the defense. There's no doubt about it. It is the defensive secondary.
Second down, a short eight now for the Buckeyes. It's George. Is outside. He got a hard hit from Brian Miller as he started to turn up and we're doing the job, Gullett. But the Buckeyes are walking backwards. You can see that Miller hit George. George is a big guy. He's 227 pounds, and Brian's trying to clear the hit.
Lumpkin in motion, top of the screen. Here's Horing back, setting up a screen. If he can get it to work. There's penetration. The people in front didn't throw a block.
There's a one-yard loss, actually, on the play. So it's third down and 17.
Boying has a lot of time, goes back to George again. The wide people are not available, and I guess they call it a fumble, huh?
Yep.
It'll be Penn State football as they knocked it loose from Eddie George.
But Nelson, number 44, gets there first, but the second man in is going to knock it loose. Can't see who that is. That's number five.
That's Scioli.
That's Scioli. That's exactly right. Keith, the holding.
Pitch to Enis.
And some daylight over the left side. He's a big strong one. And he's in the back as Whitman goes in motion. Richardson with a little quick pop. Trying to set an inside screen. And the
second part of good news there was Bobby Engram was able to work his
get up.
That's a sideline pattern. Pass intended for Green.
Four out of eight on his field goal. The kick is on its way.
Good. At 1:16 to play,
it's George. And Eddie George is out for the 30.
It's Eddie George. Hoyings pass to the sideline. Glenn, good. First down. Terry Glenn, six.
Okay, guys.
Hoyt gives the ball off to Sulu of the fullback. He isn't going anywhere. Hoyt looking around. Lets it go down the sidelines. His man is there. It is caught at the 23-yard line by Terry Glenn. Once again, second down and nine. Hoyt rolling out here. Gets away from Atkins. That'll do it. Number 93 catches up with him. Brandon Noble, 14 after the loss. Boeing going down the middle. Touchdown, Terry Glenn.
Yep.
First down, Curtis Enis and Brian Mill in the backfield. This is Enis. Found it. First down, still going. Down the sideline, big play. Penn State cooking
more and more because he has the ability.
36 yards.
He got the speed, he's got the power, he's got the patience. You're going to see a lot of
start this season. Has the ball right here. He pops it.
He's running the football. Are you as surprised about Chuck Enis as we are?
No, actually, he's my recruit, and, you know, I always bring in the classiest recruits. But I'm really happy for him. I didn't think he was going to play as much as he was this year, but he's doing well, and I knew he had the talent. And now he's there to let everybody in the rest of the country see what he has.
Describe that talent from what you saw when he was just a recruit.
Big. I mean, he's huge. He's like 230. When you look at it, you wouldn't know that. And he's shifty, and he got some speed, but he got a lot of power.
Jonathan, thank you very much.
Second down, three. And
Richardson throws it away.
Back on the sidelines, okay? Kate?
Third and 15 after the intentional grounding penalty. And Richardson lets it go. And it is incomplete, intended for Chris Kimball. Even kick is away. He had a 56-yarder his first time. This is a high hanger. Pay the price for it. Well, he's been through it. And it's Glenn. Glenn makes a catch.
First down.
Here's Hoying back again. Lets it go down the middle. Big tight end, Dudley. And Dudley has a big play to the 40th.
A great running back and a tight end that can get downfield and catch the ball.
That Calhoun checks in at fullback. Leading the blocking for Eddie George, but he bounces outside and goes for 10-11 on first down. Hoying's pass to the sidelines. Good. Boy, he couldn't have been in by much. Down to about the 32.
Earl Bruce at Iowa State was on Earl's staff at Ohio State.
Hoying looking down the middle, goes down the middle. Dudley, touchdown.
Got one catch for 20 yards. Over the run. Enis,
the tailback. And he came flying upfield and picks up
a average.
First.
Better than 10 pop. He's got it again.
By four.
Richardson, a little pop over the middle to the tight end. Olsemer.
Of college football this year.
Yeah.
This is Curtis Enis. Richardson. Quick drop, gets a little heat, there's some holding, but they got away with it. The pass is off the hand of one of the
4:07 to go in the first half. No pressure, the kick is away.
Ring is going to let this one go, and it takes a sideways bounce, and Kenya has done it again.
Nine.
And it's George. And Eddie George steps out of the hands of a would-be tackle.
Second down and three.
Look at it. Look at it. And he just keeps on changing gear. Eddie George won't get it. Nittany Lions stuck it.
Kick is out of there. Good kick. Got a little heat on him, but it's a good kick. Runs to Engram all the way back to the 23.
And still going. Look out. All the way back to the 43.
They both made it.
This is McCarchy, and that's his best effort. Richardson's pass to the sideline, got about incomplete.
Richardson again.
Oh, now they get him. I'm just about to say no pressure, and he's spun around. And Enis is running the ball on third and 20. And Ohio State. Richardson hands the ball off to Enis. Enis runs it. And up the middle. And that's some displeasure expressed from the crowd, stopping the clock at 3 seconds.
So, let's see what they decide to do.
You think you'd throw it as far as you could.
Hoying looking around, lets it go. Then, ball's thrown out of bounds. He wasn't able to keep it in. Looking for Glenn, and the half is over. A bit of confusion there at the end of the first half of play as Ohio State goes to the clubhouse leading Penn State 14 to Sualua and George. Hoying will throw it on first down, and he's going big for Tillman. And Buster,
well, he had six if he throws it in the right place.
Goes underneath this time for the first down to Terry Glenn, and Hoying hands it to Eddie George. He looks over that right side and found enough room. 23-yard line, first down. Hoying throwing on first down. Wanted to, I should say. And he's down at the 35. Hoying back to the sideline. George takes one. Nelson and keeps on pounding up the side. Hoying throws, passes caught.
is Eddie Jordan.
Pace number 75 doing a little holding on Killins. He's going to cut inside. Watch your number three. That's Herring number three that knocked it loose. I don't think he was down. No.
I think Ohio State got lucky.
Yes.
Going back. Let it go. He's got his man. Touchdown, Terry Flynn. Boy, is he having some kind of a season. Look at that. Richardson looking him over and hands the ball off. And the fullback.
They can make something happen.
Richardson dropping back. Has time and his pass is completed. Out to the 43-yard line. Stevenson, the tight end, is in the ball game now as they run it up
running back.
This is Witman. The ball first down at the Ohio State 25-yard line. They run it inside with Milne. And Enis. He got his first down. There's where that strength goes up.
That's right.
Twisted his ankle.
I don't think he was even involved in the play.
It's first down for Penn State. They're threatening here as Enis goes pounding up the middle. They've got all the big people that can round up. Third down and two for a first down. Go to Milne. He tries to go over the top. And that linesman position. Slow moving around. They go to the big guy, Witman. And Witman, I think, has the first down. He went over the top. Witman. He's in there.
He doesn't get it on the first go.
Ty Howard got him first.
Yeah.
Ty Howard's got a hold of him, and then 26 Wynn comes in.
There you go. The ball got over.
Yeah. Ball got over. 5. 21-16. Pretty dramatic little adventure down here, hasn't it? Richardson back with Rowe. He's got it. Good. Joe Jurevicius. Noise, noise, noise. Eddie George hit behind the line of scrimmage. First man was 44 Nelson, slowed him down.
Here they come.
Owens got enough daylight to get the first down and does as he crosses the floor. That is Eric Flair. Here come the Lions from just outside the 15. Ball is handed off to Mike Archie. Nope, they're going to throw it. They're going to go right at Springs. No, they go underneath Archie, and Archie's going to have the first down. They were looking at third down and five.
Oh, I tell you.
Here's a pitch to Enis. And so it looks like Penn State. Lions moving it. Enis into the outside. Big strong tailback. He's got another first down. Richardson goes to Engram. And they went to Sean Springs' side of the field. Richardson getting some pressure, gets his pass away. And it is caught by Engram. He outfought the Pitts. Winfield was over there, and Ty Howard was over there. Both.
So that means these two receivers are going to be working two-on-two on these two outside guys, the corners. Now, Joe saying, no, don't throw it up like that. Oh, no. Oh, no. Yeah, yeah, good throw.
Goal line defense now. It's first and goal from the two-yard line. And this is the big fullback, Jon Witman, touchdown.
Watch the line surge. Everybody's taken care of inside. Milne 22. You've got to beat one guy. Touchdown.
That made the touchdown possible.
I think the key point here is number 11 and number 2, the two defensive backs.
Hoyer throwing to the sidelines to Tillman, incomplete. Under the blitz, set up a screen for Eddie George, and George will get about 8 or maybe 9 yards. Third down, a yard and a half. There it is. First down and a little bit more. Boy, sideline, good. Very good. Pressure. Sack. Back at the 47-yard line by Terry Killins. And here's
Blitz. Now he's got long yardage and he's just sitting back in his own.
It's Glenn down there, intercepted by Miller. Ryan Miller brings it back to the 34-yard line. And
look at the linebackers. The linebackers are right across here. The 3-deep zone, the receiver's going to come straight down the field. It's frustration. It's long yardage. Now, if you stop it right here, here's where the interception's going to happen, right here. Watch as the defensive back plays the ball. That's just the sack on the play before set up that play. He wants to go to his main man. And Miller, who's a good defensive back, picks off. That's his first interception of the year.
The chains are broken.
Richardson back, pressure coming, pass away, overthrown, fourth down. Terry Glenn's been kind of quiet late. Going back, has some time. Pass is good to Glenn.
And on the 5 yards downfield.
They get second down and 4. It is back to the same man.
Same thing.
He's trying to move the pile. But
both teams have outstanding stats.
On 3rd and 1, George picks up. Underneath, George can't handle it. For Ohio State, this is a big play. It's caught by Dudley, and Dudley does not have a first down. He's taken. Well, you don't need any indecision here. They're going to throw it. Oh, my goodness, it is incomplete. They go for it in the corner on 4th down and 1. Terry Glenn can't reel it in. The pass was high. And Mark Tate spoiled it, and Penn State takes over.
See if it's still there. There you are. You're going out here one-on-one. The play action fake into the line. Now you got your quarterback and your best receiver. Tate has played this pretty well. The ball was thrown a little high and a little early and a little behind you.
Enis, 3rd and 15. Richardson gets it off. Pass is caught, but it's not good enough for the first down.
Game figuring in it right here. Always does. But pretty good kick there by Kenny. Nice tight spiral goes to Stanley. Gets a little daylight. And instead of hesitating, if he'd have just turned on the jet in the game. Hoying back. Gotta hurry. Gets it off, and it is incomplete. We need that tight end right here down the middle. 6'7". Dudley. There he is. Wide open. Yeah, they throw it. Got him. That's Tony. He looks at Glenn. He's not available. Down the middle, it's Dudley. The tight end makes the catch in a crowd at the 12-yard line. 25-21 Penn State. Eddie George to the 5. Eddie George. Touchdown.
football, every time you make a first down, the clock stops. So you don't need a two-minute offense. Just make first down.
Archie and Jon Witman back. Richardson lets it go. The ball is thrown to the sides to Freddie Scott. Scott's been quiet the whole second half, and suddenly, bang, there he is.
And took him right down for a score.
No pressure on him. The pass is away, right on the money to Jon Witman, and Whitman's got another first down. Well, this is Enis. Like Archie, Jon Witman at the backfield. Third down and seven. And Richardson has the ball. Picks it up, and he's still trying to find something, and suddenly he's taken down.
You can't expect a screen pass.
Got to go down the field. Richardson, Chase, lets it go. He's got Engram down there. It is incomplete. Engram out bottom to set up the Penn State last touchdown, but this time he couldn't quite get to it.
Engram on the left side and run past both corners, but the ball was underthrown and allowed him to catch up.
He got his hands on it.
Yeah.
Oh, he's tough.
There's another look. Engram is the only guy that got off his feet to catch the ball. Everybody's looking at it. Everybody's going for it. It doesn't have anybody's name on it, so it was a good call. No call, good call.
28-25, and now the Buckeyes have to run out the clock with 55 seconds, and Penn State obviously is going to spend its last time out. Clock is still running, however. The whistle fund rewarding outstanding students for academic achievements and help those in financial need. So the clock is going to be left to run out. Penn State will not spend that final one. And your final score. The Ohio State Buckeyes, ranked number 5 in the nation, continue undefeated by a breath as they beat Penn State.